Hello friends, how are you? It's been a while. So today, let's discuss about this University Recommended MEXT Scholarship, complete details like the process I have shared before also. Now again, I'm going to share some more in a more intrinsic and more detailed way where you will find useful it for many other universities also where how the University Recommended Scholarship you need to apply, what are the different schemes. There are many ways actually you will be I didn't look this way, like there are how to see the different schemes in the same university and all. So I'll be taking the example of Hokkaido University Engineering School, and also I'll be sharing how to find other schemes in the Hokkaido University, or maybe it's similar technique you can follow in other universities as well. So I found Hokkaido University, the schemes all listed in one place. I'll be showing you now. So let's go for details more later, these details. Now I'll show you the engineering school. Before engineering school, the main Hokkaido University, what is it? See, this is Hokkaido University Google search. So go to home page. So in this one, it's very clear and very interesting. See, Vision 2030, Hokkaido University has a Vision 2030. That means they are targeting some scholarships, some intakes, and also some programs and new opportunities. Everything is targeted. That is one of the information I got when I attended these programs. And now admissions, go to admissions, scholarships. So see here scholarships for prospective students, scholarships for current students. Current students, maybe we can leave it for now. Prospective students, those who want to study in Japan, those who want to apply and get the scholarships to get into Japan. So let's see the details here. So Japan government scholarships, MEXT is there. Japan university recommended university scholarships are there, and other scholarships. So MEXT scholarship, there is embassy recommended, there is university recommended. What I'm talking here is actually university recommended. There are various schemes, like some of the institutions I checked similarly for Osaka University, where I could see only one uniform intake, and inside there are different schemes. Maybe the faculty and individual schools knows. Here in Hokkaido University, unlike other universities, you can see the schemes also here. General, MEXT university recommended, and also startups and e-Asia. There is another scheme and this special scheme. In that special scheme, there is one for engineering that we will be seeing, the CQ program, and also there is a leading research and development. In EQ also there are different schemes, but this time they have merged. I'll be speaking more. So engineering leadership program and fostering this all MEXT scholarship under the different schemes or maybe projects for the university. See, fostering leading university researchers and developing bias research. This is another division or department, and another school you can say. It's not just one school, another graduate school. Environmental conservation leaders for post SDGs. So this is another school. Integrated science program, ISP program, it's there even for bachelor's. IGP program is for master's. So MJSP is also there. Global education is also there. Again, training program, this is also there for veterinary schools and international. This is another one. So there are at least seven schemes are there here. And domestic selection, no recruitment in recent years. So there is no recruitment for domestic selection. And there is university scholarships. One is the president fellowship. This is there for every president fellowship, like almost all the universities in Japan. If you are having MOU or any connection with the university, try to check with the office. You will get a chance to apply under this scheme also. I actually applied for this one and as well as MEXT, and I think you cannot get both, so they have cleared one of the application form early than the other ones. See, there are this veterinary school special programs, self-supported special grant for self-supported international students, especially for the veterinary and environmental science and chemical science and engineering. So there is some special scholarship they give support, and I know people who are studying self-funded scholarship. Yeah, these are the different schemes available. You can check in the website later, and I think it's a common. I checked in the Google Hokkaido University, and then I went to the admissions page and scholarships, so you can find all these things. Let's get into the scholarship of MEXT. This one. So I have printed the notification in eCube. That eCube MEXT scholarship. If you go for the website, in the same website, the scholarships, government scholarships. And the first one, Global Engineering Leadership Program, it is eCube, this program. So I am studying in this school. So there are many laboratories affiliated to this one, and the members introduction and the special and scholarships. current admissions, so scholarships, MEXT scholarship, you go here and you can see this form, the recent one. So there are different schemes they used to take in the past. Now they have merged into one scheme, and that is EQ special selection or uniform selection. Uniform selection, they will take care of additional schemes which are available inside the department. So what is there inside? So uniform call for Japanese MEXT scholarship through the EQ special selection. The notification information will be common, I will not go through. What I wanted to tell you, those things I'll share. Yeah, the number of positions are 4 plus 4, this is 8 positions. So this used to be like at least 3 different schemes, to my opinion. Last time when we joined, I know friends in other schemes, they joined with me and they are studying in a different name, but this still is a MEXT scholarship. And there is a field of study, 13 divisions, and qualifications, masters and doctoral. What is the required qualifications? English program, so you don't require like having Japanese skill as a mandatory. It's not mandatory. And then second page, you have the age restrictions, and you have the academic background, GPA 3 out of 4 and 80%. Minimum English requirement, that is medium of instruction certificate, or else TOEFL or IELTS, the basic score, which is there. Current country of residence, not being in Japan. So this one amount of scholarship is 144,145 for masters and PhD. Selection schedule, this is the schedule. The application is open now, you can apply now. If you are already processing, please do continue. Then screening, interview schedule is in January, and submission of additional documents by end of January, and results will be in February. And then August you'll be getting final information, and then you'll be coming to Japan by next October 2024. So these are the deadlines. Application documents, there is this the motivation and research plan. Let me read through and also I'll explain you more. So motivation to apply for research proposal, so the 2 pages excluding citations page. Motivation, you should write well, clearly, technically. I always say that, try to write technically why you are interesting, and the technical reasons like advanced technologies or the you are interested subject wise, not directly. Don't go for the life and culture in Japan, that is part of the questions, but not, it's not the priority. It's you are coming here for studies, you are applying for studies. Abstracts for graduation thesis and publications, abstracts of graduation thesis maximum 2 pages, publications maximum 2 pages. So these 3 important documents. And if you see, academic transcripts are there, it's required. Graduation, expected graduation certificates and recommendation certificate is there. In the first document you will be getting this research proposal, that is the first one, starting 2 pages. So that is important document. Mostly if you have communicated with the supervisor, it's not required, but this E-cube, they allow you to contact the supervisor and then come back to regular application process. So try to check about it. Academic transcripts, you try to get from your school, but the application period, it's not strict. You can get submit whatever you have in your hand at the moment. Graduation or expected graduation certificates also, it's important, but you can submit like enrollment period. It says that your duration of studies, that is also sufficient. Otherwise, you can ask your university, they will give simple plain cover letter which will return the expected month and year of graduation. They may need not to say like you'll be graduating, because they may, if you ask like, they'll say how I'm sure you'll be graduating, they'll make jokes. So better try to get it in normal statement where it will give the similar answer. Recommendation letter provided by supervisor and some higher authority in your place, I mean the where you are coming from. And also the cubed, yeah, it's a pre-format or the cube format. So they're giving documents through English proficiency, either of these letters, TOEFL, IELTS or English, medium of English. And yeah, these are different exams you need to submit. So some of them are very strict, some of them are not strict. You can check the details there, it's written. Additional documents, this will be requested later stage for the MEXT. Once you are cleared the selection by February, they will ask you to submit and then they will send it to the before February, before the deadline. They will say after the interview, they'll ask you to send these documents. So these documents will be going to the embassy, and embassy in Tokyo, the MEXT council, and also the MEXT will check with embassy and other they have background checks. I don't know what is exactly, nobody told in the public. So the background check details we don't know, and the contact is here in this notification. You try to feel free to contact, you will get the information very nicely, because they actually encouraging the new enrollments and intakes. And I have seen like there is argument and discussion about how to attract more Indian resources to the Japan, one side. Another side, there is an increase in the Indian immigrants over the years recently, and still they wanted to increase. And other side, there is a controversial discussion like Indians has a lot of other opportunities, like for example, they can go to any other country in Europe or USA or even other countries, because we use English well almost every time. So they say like they have more opportunities, maybe they may don't come here. It's not actually, it's like the, it's not priority like that. There is some controversial opposite discussion also. So I moreover, what I want to say now, if you are interested, if you want to come to Japan, if you want to study here and make your career built from this studies, you try here, apply for these scholarships and come here, and wish you good luck, all the best. And this deadline is very soon, so try to apply this month only. The deadline is November 20, I suppose November 20. The deadlines for application is this month, end of November, around November 28. October 23 to November 28. So I have seen some of the applicants are applying through some friends that are helping, and some of our channel members also applying. I'm hearing the news. So please do try University Recommended Scholarship. Like we discuss always, University Recommended Scholarship, the basically the research plan is important, and also the research plan, and also the supervisor contact or the recommendation, how strong he or she is recommending you internally also, that matters. And whether this I would suggest check if the lab has previously students, many students or no students. So this information sometimes may be helpful to get your anxiety or the hopes build up. Wish you good luck. Let's see again next video. Thank you.